American Cooling and Heating has the right team and the right stuff. Call anytime. Even weekend service at no extra charge. Who does that anymore? American Cooling and Heating. They'll treat you like family. Well, General Honore, first of all, how did you come to be here in Springfield, and how did you get involved with this carbon capture project in Lake Maurepas?
Well, since 2012, we created the Green Army, and our mission is to find solutions to pollution. And we work throughout the state with local communities that are having issues. As I said earlier in my presentation, it started off with Bayou Corn, when we saw the state was not taking care of its own people. You know, Louisiana is a red state. If you don't take care of a community of the reddest of the red, the most conservative people, they say, well, what is going on? Our governor ignored the people. So they called me. And from there, that's what where the Green Army was born, because it laid open the vulnerabilities of all our people in Louisiana, because they didn't follow state law. They didn't follow federal law. They did it in plain daylight. And they continued to operate, and they screwed the people and what they offered them for their home. All that's done in plain daylight, in the public eye. And they got to walk away. Nobody went to jail. They destroyed a perfectly, naturally made salt dome, 1 mile by 2 mile. Took thousands of years to create. They came in and destroyed. And it was an LLC with an address in a subdivision north of Dallas. Was able to come to Louisiana and do this. Nobody went to jail. Destroyed all the people's homes.
So what do you make of this Lake Maurepas project in particular?
It sounds like another Bayou Corn extravaganza. Don't worry about it, boss. We got it. Well, you know, just north of Bayou Corn, there's another community that was destroyed about 10 years earlier, right in the same community. And before that, 30 years ago, we had Lake Panua. We're going to go underneath Lake Panua, and we're going to extract this stuff, and we're going to put stuff in the ground. Guess what? It created a subsidence, broke the salt dome, and it changed that landscape forever. It took that water from fresh water and made it salt water. We don't know, because it hadn't been done, the confidence we need to have to be able to put this in such a sanctuary, not only a sanctuary for fish and wildlife, but a sanctuary for people. When you look at Lake Maurepas from a distance, and then you get up close on the group, you start seeing all these little dots. That's people's sanctuary. That's where they go to get their head straight, to have some peace, and to be with nature. And now right in the middle of this, we're going to put a type of well that's going to so deep in the earth that it could go through our aquifers. And then anything, the unknowns, is potential leaks from that. And we got briefed today on what pure carbon will do to you. The machines won't work. It have a permanent impact on people. And they asked us to trust them. And oh, by the way, in 10 years, they can walk away and say, Louisiana, all this shit is yours. You got to deal with it.
So why Louisiana? You know, all these things that we're doing, we're the first. For instance, this would be the largest carbon capture project on Earth so far. Why us? Why here? Why now?
Because our government is crooked, corrupt, and it's all about money. That's why they're in Louisiana. And our people, many of them, multi-generation, have made their living in oil and gas and petrochemical. They've come to trust the industry. But we're at a point in time where we figure out we can't trust the industry anymore. Not with our water, not with our air, and not with our food. I mean, just look at what BP did. A lot of South people in South Louisiana supported BP. They went out. They didn't do what they were supposed to do. They broke that wellhead. They lied about it. They said they were going to take care of the cleanup work. We got over 3,000 cleanup workers that never got their health care. Now they're having to go to court. That's over 12 years ago. And people are still suffering. They lied and they got away with it. That's why they come to Louisiana.
You said in your speech that carbon capture is a Ponzi scheme, that the whole basis of this technology simply will not work.
The whole idea behind is a potential Ponzi scheme. The technology hadn't been proven, and people are motivated to do it because of carbon credits. So you're running a process that have not been proven, but if you can say you've done this, there's no way to measure what they're going to really do because they won't be monitored, right? So they will tell the federal government, this is what we did, and this is how much tax credit you got to now give us. You with me?
So looking at this crowd and what you have learned about this project and vetting the opposition to it, what do you expect to happen?
I expect they will push this through because the governor's for it and the oil and gas companies want it so they can get more tax break. People got to understand, when we drill a well in Louisiana, people say, well, we get royalties. No, we don't get royalties on a well in Louisiana for 3 years if it's on the land. By the time the states start to get money from the well, most of them, they've sucked everything out of them. Offshore, in federal waters, when they drill a well, like BP well that was out there, they don't have to pay royalties or tax until they pay the debt off. I've got to get our lawyers to check to see if that's the case with Lake Maurepas, because it's a well in the water. It is quite possible that they will not have to pay the state or anybody any tax or any royalties that may be made off that process until they pay the debt off. So you're getting free money, then you're being subsidized for doing good by being able to get tax credit.
But you expect that this will ultimately happen?
Oh, hell yeah. This is, we may be able to slow it down, but this is moving at warp speed. We just capped a well in the Atchafalaya with federal money, owned by a big oil and gas company. Guess what they're gonna do at that site? Carbon capture. All of that approved in a matter of days and weeks. Because as soon as they can say they're pushing carbon in there, they start getting tax credit. Now, we use state and federal money to cap a well in the Atchafalaya Basin that belongs to a company last year that made $54 billion profit. We use federal and state money to cap it, because it's been designated as a carbon capture well. What a deal, huh?
Well, of course, it doesn't make sense that you would produce more carbon, not less, which would be the case with the Lake Maurepas project, and that you're not taking care of it, you're not disposing of it, you're just moving it from place to place.
The only reason all of this is going on is that ammonia and the other stuff that they told you about, that they want to take out natural gas, convert it to fertilizer, convert it to LNG or whatever, ship it overseas. Natural gas here sells about anywhere between $6 and $4 and $5, or sometime up to $8. They turn it into natural gas and serve it overseas, and they sell it for 10 times that amount. It's a money-making scheme. We don't use LNG. We have enough fertilizer in America. This is to nothing but a scheme by people who never get their foot dirty. These are investors that have created this scheme.
So you say you're pessimistic that we can prevail, but on the other hand, what advice do you give to the local opponents?
We have to fight like hell. We have to push back. We have to delay. We've had some success in St. James Parish because we fought to delay, and they're losing their investment money. This company has come in with enough investment money. They're not struggling for money because they're a big company. They're in the petrochemical business. But the prize they see is to run a program where they're going to get tax breaks from Louisiana, and they're going to get carbon credit for doing something that they would normally just let loose in the air and nobody would say nothing.
So what if the Republicans take back Congress, or for that matter the presidency, in the 24 elections? Wouldn't that reverse some of this Green New Deal funding that is the basis for all this?
Yeah. Yes and no. Right now, they like the idea that we're giving carbon credits because it gives cover to the big oil and gas company. They're putting solar fields in, they get carbon credit. You understand? They're going to put the wind fields in, they're going to get carbon credit. The more LNG they produce in Louisiana, it goes overseas, whoever buys it, say, hey, we're using LNG, they're going to get carbon credit. They're going to take the carbon and put it under the ground, supposedly, they're going to get carbon credit. It's all a way, it's a Ponzi scheme to pay less tax and to get more money from the state government to encourage them to come here to create jobs.
Tell us some good news.
The good news is, as a people, we can come together, we can talk, we can take action, we can express ourselves, and we can do our First Amendment right. That's the great nation of the world. We couldn't do this in Russia. We couldn't do this in China. We couldn't stand here and speak our mind. That's the great news about America.
Great news. There's someone you can call for fast, reliable service on your air conditioning. American Cooling and Heating, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Friendly people who are experts at what they do. 25 years in business with lots of satisfied customers. Old-fashioned service plus the wherewithal to get the job done right. American Cooling and Heating,